Obviously, we've been moving along, we've been progressing, but this, it just feels different, right? It's day one. It's our first day. This is the first step of our journey. I want it to be long, I want it to be successful, I want it to be productive. And you don't just make that happen later. It's every single day, okay? You gotta be great today, right? So we're gonna ask you to continue to be great, but man, you gotta bring it, okay? With great intensity, remembering what you're working for. Okay, if you forget, just glance up that way. It's a big deal.
Lock in, 1, 2, 3.
Lock in.
The 2023-2024 basketball season is upon us.
Quick.
And with that, Kelly Harper's fifth year leading the program.
My vision for this program was to compete for championships, to play well enough and to improve throughout the year that we could be peaking and playing our best in March so that we are striving towards, moving towards getting back to the Final Four for national championships.
In four seasons, Coach Harper has taken the team to back-to-back Sweet 16s and an appearance in the SEC Tournament Championship game last season.
You know, I think our team has tasted a little bit of success. I think success breeds success. You've got to know what you want. You have to have the vision. You have to see what you can do. You've got to see who you can be, and you've got to really strive for that.
When you step out on the court, it's an opportunity. It's an opportunity for you to get better, and it is an opportunity that you will never get back.
Even with the recent success, Coach Harper knows that this team can do more, that this program expects more. And that's exactly what preseason is for, preparing your team to do more.
Going into this preseason, we're really building upon a successful summer. I think we had a lot of players get in the gym and improve on their skill set this summer. We've wanted to see that continue. A couple of our big focuses, one has been defensively, individually, and as a team. Two, we know that we've got to continue to work on our rebounding. We graduated some pretty high statistical rebounders, so we've got to make sure we cover that with this team. And then our pace. We've worked really hard on our pace, trying to get that up, trying to allow our team to play free but very aggressive in transition.
Not only does Kelly Harper have high expectations for her athletes on the court this season. But she also has high expectations off the court as well.
Each player that we have in our program is different. We want to meet them where they are. Their needs are different than their teammates. And so to help them and to help develop them off the court as well, you have to spend time with them. You have to genuinely love them. And our players know that. They know we love them. They know we care for them. We hold them accountable off the court. We really push them to excel academically. We push them to excel in the community. So many things that we're doing helps them be successful and productive women in our society.
Some goals that I have for myself is just to be the best player that I can be on and off the court and just cheer my teammates on and just be that everything go-to player that I can be.
One athlete who has benefited from the leadership of Kelly Harper is Rekia Jackson, who decided to forego the WNBA draft in April in order to get one more season on Rocky Top.
Are you ready for the first day of practice?
Yeah.
What led to my decision of coming back was just Tennessee as a whole. Just the family atmosphere, my teammates, my coaches. They just make it feel such at home, a home away from home, and I just wasn't ready to leave the nest yet. I also wanted to develop my game on the court more to be more ready for the WNBA. I can see this coaching staff helping to develop my game more this year by just continuing to push me and just know the player and the person that I want to be on and off the court, polish my game, my handles, my shot, just raise my IQ even more, just have more grit. You know, they just bring that grit out of me, they bring that toughness out of me, so they can help in a lot of ways, and they've been doing just that.
You know, we have really moved her around a lot this fall in terms of position and what we've asked her to do. And I think she feels really comfortable.
Watch the ball.
Rakia brings a lot to our team on the court, just her versatility, her competitiveness. I mean, she's an athlete, an elite athlete all the way around. It's just impressive to sit there and watch her sometimes. Being on the floor with her, I'll throw the ball, and instead of moving, as Coach Kelly likes us to do, I just want to sit there and watch.
She knows she wants to be in the WNBA, but she's very present. She understands this is an important year for our basketball team, and she has high expectations for this team.
This is going to be a fun year with some fun girls. Stay tuned.
Another player who has improved her game at Tennessee is senior guard Tess Darby, who was looking to be a veteran leader for the group this season.
As a fourth-year player, she has really developed her fitness level. She's developed her skill set, her confidence, her fight, her want to win comes through more now. She gets in the gym and shoots probably more than anyone else on the team, and it pays off.
Come on, y'all got it.
I think Tess understands there's a need on our team for someone to step up and have a voice, for someone to step up and have leadership qualities on the court. And Tess's tone, Tess's approach is always so positive. It's always well received by her teammates.
Tess, go get behind Kaya, but you don't need your ball.
Being a freshman with Renaya Davis, she kind of took me underneath her wing. So now just being a leader and upperclassman, I want to do the same for the underclassmen. Just being a person they can go to and lean on. Just anything that they may need, I want to be that person for them.
This year's squad is full of experience with its other returners, like Tamari Key, who is back for a fifth year after a blood clot scare ended her season early last year. Caroline Striplin and Jillian Hollingshed, who saw big minutes during Tamari's absence. Point guards like Jasmine Powell, Kaya Wynn, and Edie Darby, and scorers like Sarah Puckett. But experience is not just limited to those who played just for UT last season. The Lady Vols saw a lot of success in the transfer portal with additions of players like Jewel Spear, Destiny Wells, Avery Strickland, and Talasia Cooper.
I was ready for a little bit bigger stage, and playing in that arena, it was so nice, and playing in front of those fans. I mean, it was so many. It was like nothing I ever seen before. So I just kind of wondered, like, what it would be like to play in front of something like that, and here I am.
Tennessee reached out, and I really just fell in love from not only growing up in Tennessee, but just knowing what the legacy is about, meeting the girls and the coaches. It was just a new home for me.
Basketball seasons are long, and with a new group of young women, it's important that the team gets along with one another. And building those relationships starts early.
Working on our team chemistry and camaraderie is always going to be something we're doing. You never check the box there and say, hey, we're good, we're moving on. It's something you always work on. But right now, I'm really proud of where we are.
Let it be known that Rikiski is my best friend.
JP Ski!
Rikiki!
I think this team genuinely likes being around each other. I think they genuinely pull for each other. I think we're on the same page in terms of our vision and where we want to go. As we continue to grow as a team, as we continue to get into the meat of our season, we'll continue to try to foster those relationships.
When the Lady Vols take the court for the first time this season, they all know what they're fighting for.
We have talked about our vision. We have worked really hard on the court. We are continuing to push. We are continuing to find ways to be better. Each and every day, we are promoting the family culture. We are promoting a togetherness, a united front, all for one reason. And that ultimately is always going to be the goal here at Tennessee, to win a national championship.